Spice Girls, in a little over a year, have forced their way onto the American cultural radar. There have been hit singles.
We're just nonstop.
Flashy videos.
Exactly. Buzzing with positive energy.
Tabloid scandals.
It's complete lies.
Meetings with world leaders.
And Nelson Mandela. Yep. Don't forget the man.
And breakup rumors.
We are sticking together.
So what better time for a Spice Girls movie? Spice World is a 5 days in the life mockumentary of the girls' misadventures leading up to their first live concert ever.
So let me ask you about the film, Spice World. How did the idea come about? I had read that Simon, your former manager, was actually one of the people who had sort of come up with the idea initially. Is that
incorrect?
Is that
incorrect?
Okay.
I'll tell you why.
I stand corrected.
Incorrect. Basically, Spice Girls had, you know, the idea of this movie literally four or five years ago when we went to Simon. That was just one of our ideas that we actually had.
In fact, the idea was brewing even before these five girls from England backflipped their way up the charts and into the hearts of so many. Was it all a Machiavellian plan staged by manipulative managers? The Spicers maintain it was their modest philosophy of girl power that made them stars.
When you're first brought together by another producer who will remain nameless.
There's only four of us.
Yes, but were you all like working as session singers at that time?
Mm-hmm. I'd done quite a lot of session work, but we were also like dancing and acting, and you'd done a lot of presenting as well, didn't you? So we were doing all kinds of stuff.
Were you doing anything that we would remember fondly now?
We won't tell you even if we
come
were.
Come on.
You're going to find out anyway.
If you want my future, forget my past. But when your past includes nude modeling, as in the case of Ginger Spice, it's bound to catch up with you sooner or later. Still, most of the Spice Girls' history reads like an episode of Fame, beginning in 1994 with a casting notice that read, "Are you 18 to 23 with the ability to sing and dance? Are you streetwise, outgoing, ambitious, and dedicated?" As it happens, Victoria Adams, Melanie Chisholm, Melanie Brown, and Jerry Halliwell fit the bill. They auditioned and were chosen to form the group Touch. That name was dropped, and they eventually settled on Spice Girls. The father and son management team that brought them together put them up in a house and gave them dancing and singing lessons. With the addition of the final Spice, Emma Bunton, the girls worked at strengthening their voices and perfecting their harmonies, all in hopes of landing a record deal.
Now you have like harmonies and stuff. Have you worked on this a lot? When you first got together, did you have to go in a room somewhere and just bat it all out?
Yeah, we spent a lot of time. Yeah, we lived together, didn't we? And when we were writing, we were singing together and getting all the foundations down.
And then when we were in the institute together, we had a lot of time.
Of course, there's lots of time there.
As they honed their talents, the girls grew anxious for more creative freedom and in turn came to resent their management teams trying to control their every move.
Although, you know, we're five young girls, we've got five strong heads on our shoulders, you know what I mean? We're a bit of intelligence and, you know, we always go on our gut instinct, you know, and basically stay true to ourselves. So if we don't like something, we just say it.
We don't do it.
Not liking the direction the group was going in, they parted ways with their management and turned to Annie Lennox manager Simon Fuller, who agreed to give the girls a bit more creative input, both musically and otherwise.
The history of pop music with women in it is often that they get ripped off. Are you making money from this?
We don't get ripped off.
Are you controlling your business?
Yeah, we are.
Well, one
got
thing,
a cool manager as well, so everything's sorted, really.
We wanted to go as a package. We knew what we wanted. We knew how we wanted to write our songs. We knew how we wanted to dress. We knew ideas for videos and everything.
July of 95, the girls were signed to Virgin Records and began in earnest to work on their debut album, Spice. The record became a true pop sensation, topping America's year-end charts for 1997 and selling over 18 million copies and counting worldwide. The girls announced their presence to the globe with a first single that promptly went to number one in 32 countries.
If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends, make it last forever.
It's been a long time since dance pop has been really big in the States.
Yeah.
But this seems to be the time again. Why do you suppose that is?
I think everything goes in circles, and I think pop music could be back.
After scoring two more top five hits with Say You'll Be There and To Become One, a backlash unique to dance pop phenom set in. But the group has always seemed to take the knocks in stride and to laugh along with its harshest critics.
Spice Girls are kind of like heroin. You know somebody's doing it, but nobody admits it.
In fact, their renowned nicknames, Scary, Baby, Posh, Ginger, and Sporty, were originally printed as a diss on them by the British music magazine Top of the Pops. But the ever-cheeky Spice Girls adopted the monikers and made them their own.
Yeah, I'm always going to be seen as Baby Spice, you know, the sweet and innocent one. Even when I'm 30.
You love it, really, Emma. You play up to it all the time.
No, I don't.
Do you all pretty much live up to your images? I mean, are you really, like, the fitness person?
Now that's one thing, you see. The image. It's not an image, it's natural. That's the way we are.
Well, you see, what you get.
Yeah, exactly. That's the way we've always been. It's just that, because we didn't want to suppress anyone in this band.
Their sassy, non-threatening personas seemed a natural fit for advertisers. And so began a wave of Spice-related endorsements. The girls have peddled everything from potato crisps to dolls to cameras and candy. And then, of course, there was the requisite soft drink contract. As part of their deal with that soda company, a contest was held to see the Generation Next girls perform their first full-length concert in Istanbul, Turkey.
It was the first time we did sort of like 15 numbers. You know, we had a lot of rehearsal time, and it was like it was a preview to our concert.
Why did we pick Turkey? That was mad. I mean, it's not the most, I would say, comfortable place on earth. I used to work as the game show hostess there. I knew what it was like.
What's that got to do with anything?
So I knew what it was like. We are an international band now. I think, you know, we're like nomads travelling through the desert and on our camels. You know, wherever we lay our hat is our home, basically.
I love the world.
Yeah.
Everywhere. It's
this
fantastic.
Whole world. It's quite mad. Because you out there, right, we were like, we were on, I think you call it welfare here. Right, about 5 years ago, and we had no money.
And we were living on beans on toast.
And that proves, you know, now we have been all around the world and back again. Do you know what I mean?
And that proves whoever you are, whatever you do, you can do it.
Here we go!
Next, does trouble lie ahead for the Fabulous Five? And the answer to the burning question, can the Spice Girls act?
Blah, 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 girl power, feminism, do you know what I mean?
Well.
Have you got a feeling that people are beginning to be tired of you, or
no, they're not, all right, sit down!
With their debut album still in the top 20, the Spice Girls held a press conference in Granada, Spain, to herald the release of their sophomore album, Spice World, the upcoming release of Spice World the Movie, and plans for their 98 world tour. With their three-pronged plan of attack, the Fabulous Five appeared well-poised, if not to give birth to the world, to conquer it.
What is with the globe thing on the album? Is this sort of a world domination concept?
No, not domination. It's just we've travelled a lot of the world and we've seen fantastic places and we feel like that's really influenced our second album. The world's a small place, you know, we should come together and unite as one.
In every nation.
Spice Up Your Life was actually inspired by a trip that we had in Acapulco. So it's got a kind of Latin American feel to it. So that's another reason for all the worlds.
Being one of the Spice Girls, being part of the team, being part of the mad mission, gives you kind of an insight to all different cultures.
Having soaked up all that culture, in June of last year, the Spice Girls were called back to London for the making of Spice World, their film debut, and to write and record their second album.
It was excellent because during the film, we had such a good vibe, we were having a laugh with each other, and it was easy to write the music.
Did you have your producers?
Yeah, we had this built-in, it was like a little caravan, the studio in there.
Yeah.
So when the day was finished shooting, we'd go in and start writing. Never remember the good time.
Long days though, right?
But we got girl power, we can survive it, man.
There's a lot more musical kind of diversity on this record as compared to the first album. Was that important?
Diversity is unity, really. You know, the way we feel, you know, we want to express ourselves in different areas. You know, creatively, we love to let it rip.
Jerry's a massive fan of old, I mean, old music. We did a big band 40s song with me. I love Motown. I was brought up with Motown music, and we did Stop.
Stop right now. Thank you very much. I need somebody with a human touch.
And at the end of the day, you cater for everybody's needs, but then you appreciate them as well. Do you know what I mean? We can all get down to anything. Yeah.
Too much of nothing is just as tough.
Too Much is going to be the next video here. Can you talk a little bit about, it seems like you've each got your own little scene in that video. And were they inspired by films?
Yeah,
they
suggested
are
ideas. Of movies.
Yeah.
They are. You've got the, you did the Poltergeist.
I was the girl in the Poltergeist.
And Mel B, she's
Mad Max.
Mad Max. Mel C, she's Year of the Dragon. Victoria's Catwoman.
Catwoman.
And I did, it was a Casablanca-y kind of Rita Hayworth.
The first album sold brilliantly, and the second album we wanted to be just as good, but we always like to please us, you know, we want to do what we want to do, and then hopefully if the fans enjoy it as well, that's an extra bonus.
Yeah.
That extra bonus, however, was slow in coming. With lackluster first week sales and a disappointing chart entry at number 8, Spice World's initial failure to live up to the expectations set by the debut album caused critics to question the act's shelf life.
They've had a lot of success very quickly, so get ready for the backlash.
And when the group was apparently booed off stage during an appearance in Barcelona, Spain, it seemed that the sun was beginning to set on Spice World.
Your 15 minutes is up, little girl! Get back to us!
You know, all the booing, that, there was not one fan in there booing. It was press, and it was people booing at the press. And I tell you what, when we left, you know,
the booing,
the place where the booing was happening. We went outside and there were just hundreds of fans cheering with banners, and that is what really mattered.
They weren't booing, they were screaming.
The Spice World only entered at number 8, but each week since then it's actually increased sales.
Only number eight.
Well,
we are only number 8.
It's your world, Victoria.
Come on,
baby.
Fantastic, but as you say, album sales, you know, are rocketing over here, and we're so excited.
By the end of the year, with Spice World going platinum and gaining chart momentum, there was much for the girls to be excited about. Some in the media, however, continued to predict their demise, citing breakup rumors that followed the sacking of the band's manager of 3.5 years, Simon Fuller.
Can you tell me anything about how that came down, letting Simon go?
No.
Nothing.
Nothing. No.
All we can say. There's a lot of speculation about what happened.
Speculation, and you know, we'd love to tell you, but we can't for legal reasons.
You were at the center of the big rumor about, you know, that there was a relationship.
No, it wasn't true about that at all.
Come on.
That was rubbish.
At the end of the day, you think, I was speaking to the guy from Aerosmith the other day. You know, what's his name?
Steven Tyler.
Steven Tyler. And he's got
He's had some management.
He's gone through how many managers. I don't know.
But I didn't know about that. Janet Jackson's only just, you know.
Change management.
But it's not a big deal. No, it's not a big thing.
That's part of the course, isn't it? Sacking your management.
No, but we are stronger than ever and we are doing our own thing.
Of course, doing their own thing does at times raise eyebrows. Take, for example, the girls' saucy breaches in protocol when encountering the royal family.
You guys, of course, recently got to meet Harry and Charles again in South Africa.
Did.
How did that go?
That was mad.
Really mad, yeah. He's a very normal little boy. Very nice, very warm. Charles is a very warm man as well.
A lot of people made about a lot of the fact that, you know, you gave him a little squeeze a few months ago. But is that too much made of that?
Thing is, you know, us, we always just, you know, are ourselves. You know, that is my sense of fun. Do you know what I mean? I'm quite a cheeky person, really. But if people want to read into that, what they should read into that is what we were saying before, everybody is human, even Prince Charles is.
We'd like to dedicate this award to Princess Diana, who was a great loss for our country.
A loss shared by the Spice Girls as well, who sported black armbands in Diana's memory at last year's MTV Video Music Awards. Later in the year, the girls contributed the track Mama, off their first record, to a Diana tribute album.
Mama, I love you. Mama, I care.
In the wake of Diana's death, there was a lot of speculation that the press would kind of take this more restrained kind of approach. Is there any sign that they've sort of learned any lessons?
I don't think so. They said they
would. British press is British press.
There's English paparazzi down there. They follow us everywhere.
But you know, the thing is, in our profession, we've got to accept that because it is part of the job.
The bottom line is, sometimes they do go a bit too far.
Yeah.
It is.
Finishing set it in a nutshell. Set it in a nutshell.
This is in a nutshell. Hey, I'm in a nutshell.
When we come back, the Spice Girls take on the media in Spice World.
I put them up there. I can bring them down.
Don't worry, there won't be any fans out here. They're all around the front.
Okay. Okay.
Sorted.
Spice World the movie offers a glimpse into the hectic existence of pop's phenomenon du jour, taking fans along for the ride as they careen from photo shoots to TV shows to concert rehearsals, all on a mammoth double-decker bus driven like a bat out of hell by none other than Meatloaf.
That movie is basically a parody of our lives. You know, our lives, I would say, they are, compared to the average person, it is really mad. You know, we get up, we're in makeup, and we go to Top of the Pops, and we do another interview, and we go to that TV show. And
then we fly to Spain, and then
we fly to Spain, and come back, and then do this, and do the phone
it's
up.
Probably madder than the film actually shows, actually.
Action.
With veteran Britcom director Bob Spears at the helm, filming on Spice World was crammed into 43 days last summer. Shot entirely in and around London, the movie's hometown locales helped give it a distinctly British feel. But the Spice Girls are banking on what they see as the film's universal appeal.
It's a British comedy. Of course it's, dedicated to our Spice Girl fans, but we feel, as audience goes, going to appeal to everybody and anybody if you've got a sense of humour.
A lot of the situations that happen in the movie, it actually things that have really happened but obviously a bit elaborated on to make them more entertaining.
Can you give me any specific scenes that actually...
Jumping off a bus and escaping.
We did do that in England.
We got
in trouble.
Oh, look, your knickers go!
And I did actually drive the bus, you see, while they were all in it. Generally, people think that, I'm quite sort of serious. I'm really very boring.
She's not.
It's always the same. I never know what to wear.
Yeah, it must be really hard for you, Victoria. Trying to decide whether to wear the little Gucci dress, or the little Gucci dress.
Exactly.
Do you think people do have the impression that you take yourself very seriously?
But we know the real
thing is, look at the state of us Spice Girls. How can they take themselves seriously?
Or much else for that matter. During the course of Spice World, the group takes satirical stabs at the music industry, the tabloid press, Hollywood movies, and themselves. In one scene, the girls have fun trying on each other's personas.
I'm just too posh.
My mummy's my best friend.
It was a parody of everything, really, of us,
the media.
Press, right?
Yeah, it was just, we think if you can't take the piss out of yourselves and the media, who can you, they should be able to laugh at it.
But you do like boys, don't you, Jerry?
Come on, is the Pope a Catholic?
Here at home, church leaders have reacted with shock today to reports that the Spice Girls have cast doubt on the religious conviction of the Pope.
With scenes involving intrusive paparazzi and scandal-happy media, Spice World's humor seems particularly timely, maybe too timely. During the course of the filming, references to Princess Diana, Gianni Versace, and Mother Teresa all had to be deleted.
In a lot of ways, the film and real life it's really very bizarre.
Yeah,
isn't it?
I mean, there's that expression, isn't it, about art follows real life and life
imitating art.
That's it.
No alien encounters in real life.
I don't
had
know.
Ghost encounters, I think, of the spiritual kind of vibe, man.
But I believe, Men in Black, I think, that's a bit of truth behind that. Yeah.
When not signing autographs for aliens, the girls share the screen with Spice World's impressive host of celebrity guest stars from the worlds of TV, film, and music.
Bob, I think you look great.
What the hell have you done?
We just bribed them.
You bribed the kids. No, what happened was,
to be in it.
When we first started out doing a movie, we got a really big cast list, like Arnold Schwarzenegger, Sylvester Stallone,
Marilyn Monroe,
everyone.
Elvis.
And then we said, now, come on, we've got to be realistic. Who fits the parts in the film?
Girl power, equalization between the sexes.
Any scene in the film that you guys really enjoyed hated?
I've got one.
There was this one where we had to do this assault course, an army thing.
It was mad.
We're the Spice Girls, yes, indeed. In a wonder bra.
I've got got this scene that was my particular favourite. It was this love scene with Brad Pitt, but it was that steamy, it ended up on the cutting room floor.
We had lots of, you know, live performances in the film as well. I think we all really enjoyed as well. Yeah.
This summer, fans will have ample opportunity to see the group perform in the flesh as they set out on their first world tour. And don't rule out the chance of a Spice World sequel.
Possibly. Maybe it's on the first one. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Exactly. People might hate it.
But then again, we might just do one anyway to piss everybody off.
But we like it.
Well, what would you like to see happen in the sequel? All over the world kind of thing?
Lots of big steamy love crash.
Airplane 3.
Yeah, give me the money, mothers! Okay!
That's
the trailer, right? This is it. Okay, go and see the press movie, otherwise Posh gets it!